A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27 September, on the front page you have Karnataka bipolls will be deferred. Election Commission tells Supreme Court. So the Election Commission has told the Supreme Court that it would defer the by-elections to 15 Karnataka Assembly constituencies till the court finally decided the petitions of the MLAs who represented those constituencies until they were disqualified by then Speaker of Karnataka, K.R. Ramesh Kumar, under anti-defection law. So, this you should know the background. It was the former Speaker who had disqualified these MLAs after they had resigned. Actually, they had submitted the resignation letters, but the Speaker did not accept them. The Supreme Court had intervened at that time too, and it had said that no decision should be taken by the Speaker on this matter immediately, by a deadline or something. But the Speaker said that the judiciary cannot impose restrictions and deadlines on the post of the Speaker. Even recently, we have seen the present Speaker of Karnataka Legislative Assembly approaching the Supreme Court to asking it to put guidelines for the post of Speaker, but judiciary declined it, saying that Speaker's post is a constitutional authority and judiciary cannot intervene in that, cannot put guidelines for that. So now the news is that those 15 seats by elections are required because they had resigned. The 15 MLAs had resigned, but then even after resignation, the Speaker disqualified them. So anyway, the posts become vacant. Thing is that if they are disqualified, they cannot contest elections. But if they have resigned, they can contest elections and win those seats if they can. So that's the whole background. It was the Congress-JDS coalition government where these members, to whom these 15 members belonged, but they shifted their allegiance. They have resigned and they joined the BJP. So that's it. Then this is Punjab sees increase in farm fires this month. So significant September spike is being seen in stubble burning here in Punjab, because of which Delhi's winter air pollution can rise. We have seen every year that stubble burning in adjoining states of Punjab and Haryana results in air pollution in Delhi because of the circulatory system as such here to the how the air circulation takes place, because of which all this polluted air accumulates in Delhi and causes severe air pollution. Then below you have Modi meets Rouhani, discusses Chabahar. So this is Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Iranian President Hassan Rouhani, who met on the sidelines of the UN General Assembly meet in New York. And here you can see Prime Minister Narendra Modi stressed on the need for peace in Iran, in the Gulf region. Also, you should know about the Chabahar port, which India is developing here. And the two leaders spoke of operationalizing Chabahar port as soon as possible and its importance. It is actually a gateway to Afghanistan and the Central Asian region for India. So this is here. On page 5 you have, can't rely only on regional assessment reports. So this is National Green Tribunal, which has a petition before it challenging the environment clearance granted to 12 minor mineral sand mining projects in Uttar Pradesh. So here the NGT has held that regional environment impact assessment, regional EIA reports cannot be the sole basis for approval of projects. It says that a regional EIA is a macro level tool which only gives representative idea of impacts in general in large area. It is just an indicative tool, gives a bird's eye view. So it says individual environment impact assessment has to be done, or cluster based EIA has to be done, and then only clearance can be provided. On page 7 you have ECI, Election Commission of India, cell to monitor fake news, poll code violations on social media. So cybercrime officials are looking out for content that may give rise to law and order trouble ahead of assembly elections in Maharashtra. This is flooding in Pune actually. Then on page 8 you have government takes control of Kerala church. So members of Jacobite faction court arrest after high drama at St. Mary's church in Piravum. So we had seen this in news, that is also the front page news. We can see the image on the front page in today's paper too. So this is in Ernakulam in Kerala. So the district administration has taken control of St. Mary's church here. There is high drama involving members of rival Jacobite and Orthodox factions. So because of this, Kerala High Court, actually the Kerala High Court had ordered removal of supporters of the Jacobite faction from the church premises. So now they are courting arrest, and here you can see government has taken control of the church. Below you have Krishna in spate for third time. So increase in inflows here has forced authorities to let out 2.52 lakh Q6 from Srisailam. So this is, you can see, Srisailam dam across the Krishna River in Andhra Pradesh. Because of the increase in the inflows, the inflow has increased from 1.3 lakh Q6 in the morning to 2.1 lakh Q6 in evening. So the authorities had to release 2.5 lakh Q6 to prevent water from spilling over the crest of the reservoir. Then below you have DMIT fingerprint test is medical palmistry. So this is dermatoglyphics multiple intelligence test. So many doctors in India have questioned this practice. They call it medical palmistry, the effectiveness of this test. It's a popular test used on school children as a scientific study of fingerprints, patterns and human brain lobes to determine the intrinsic potential in children. But Indian Psychiatric Society has now urged schools and parents to stay away from such ill-founded practices. So this is another palmistry as such, which should not be indulged in. On the editorial page, the first editorial is subject to people's will. So this is regarding the disqualified rebels, the 15 as such MLAs who have been disqualified. So they should not be barred from bipolls in Karnataka is what this article also says. So Election Commission of India is agreeing to defer by elections till the Supreme Court now hears the matter. So actually defection is on charges of shifting sites. So if a politician, while he is elected and while he has won a seat, he changes his party, then it is called defection. But if they have disqualified, if they have resigned and then they are joining any other political party and trying to win the seat on that political party's ticket, then it is not disqualification in the essence of the term. So Supreme Court is also going to hear this matter. So we'll see. And this is Trump and impeachment. So it says he may find it hard to shrug off the charge of leaning on Kyiv to meddle in domestic politics. So Kyiv is the capital of Ukraine. So this was front page news yesterday. Impeachment proceedings would be initiated against President Trump for trying to pressure Ukraine to take action against the Democrat candidate for presidential elections 2020, that is Joe Biden. Then next is the lead article, childhoods lost in troubled paradise. So it is said Kashmiri's children are growing up traumatized by the conflict going on, and they live in perpetual fear of being picked up by the state, by the police. And this is institutions weakened, economy crippled. So this is regarding how institutions in the country are being weakened. You can see examples are being given here. Erosion of RBI's autonomy. Then even Niti Aayog, it's actually presents a case for institution that's lost its character in the process of transformation. So Niti Aayog was also supposed to be a transforming institute as such, but National Institute for Transforming India, but then it has also lost its character. Then we have seen even other institutions like Central Statistical Organization and others which have also lost their credibility. So there are three institutions which are picked up and detailed out here. Niti Aayog also replaced the Planning Commission. The RBI, CSO and Niti Aayog. Then on Fridays, you have the Parle coverage in which the question posed is, how can the Indian economy ride out the storm? So it says, unless rural incomes hit by demonetization are revived, consumer demand is not going to grow. Then on page 12, you have NSA discusses steps to ease Jammu and Kashmir curbs. So National Security Advisor Ajit Doval is camped in Srinagar ahead of Prime Minister Narendra Modi's address at UN General Assembly in New York. And for the past week, security officials have been making arrangements to ensure no violence is reported in Kashmir in the wake of high-profile event, as it might affect India's image globally. Then, on page 13, you have UNSC allows Hafiz Saeed banking access. So, United Nations Security Council 1267 committee has allowed Pakistan-based UN-designated terrorist Hafiz Saeed limited access to his otherwise sanctioned bank account. So, Hafiz Saeed is wanted by India in connection with the 2008 Mumbai terror attacks, and now UNSC has decided to ease, the restrictions which have been imposed in response to a request made by Pakistan to which no objections were raised. And then here you have Daewoo in Saab out of submarine tender. So, this is Swedish Defence Major Saab, which has pulled out of contest to supply Navy with 6 advanced conventional submarines under Project 75i. So, South Korea's Daewoo Shipping has now made a last minute entry. And this is high drama at SAARC's ministers meet. So, SAARC is a regional grouping, South Asian Association for Regional Cooperation. So, ministers from SAARC had a meet. But Pakistan and India ministers, each of them boycotted each other's statements at the meeting. The meet took place in New York. You can see on the sidelines of the UN General Assembly meet taking place too. On international page, you have White House sought to conceal records of Trump's Ukraine call. So this is what the whistleblower says in the case, and because of evidence provided now, US President Donald Trump's impeachment process will also be initiated. So the whistleblower says that White House officials witnessed the president abuse his office for personal gains. Such are the allegations being made. On business page, you have growth to pick up in second half, Finance Minister. So, Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman has said that India's economic growth is likely to pick up from October to March period as consumer demand is expected to improve. She says private sector lenders see strong demand in rural areas. And this is SEBI hauls up mutual funds over standstill pacts. So, SEBI has pulled up mutual funds by entering into standstill agreements with promoters and has clarified that regulations do not have provisions for such arrangement between corporates and asset management companies. So, companies, they cannot pay them, the mutual funds as such. Investors, they invest in various various companies. So, now because the companies cannot pay them, they enter into standstill agreement with promoters of these companies. So, SEBI is saying that regulations do not allow such standstill pacts. So, they are ready to wait along with them. So, rules bar such agreements is what SEBI chief says. And this is, call money rates should be close to policy rates, says liquidity panel. So, this is an internal working group formed by RBI to review current liquidity management framework. Has suggested that framework should be guided by objective of maintaining the target rate. That is the rate in the interbank market for reserves. So that should be close to policy rate is what this internal working group says. And this is PMC bank depositors can withdraw 10,000, says RBI. So earlier it had allowed only 1,000 rupees to be withdrawn. Now RBI has allowed the depositors to withdraw 10,000, and it says 60% of depositors will be able to withdraw full amount. And this is GSK recalls ranitidine after cancer-causing substance detected. So there were these suspicions, but now they have been confirmed that ranitidine contains cancer-causing substances, a carcinogen. So GlaxoSmithKline said it voluntarily recalls ranitidine hydrochloride tablets produced in India. Then on the last page you have new snake named after Shiv Sena chief's son. So this is a new species of snake which has been discovered in the Western Ghats and in Maharashtra, and it has been named after Tejas Thakre, the younger son of Shiv Sena chief Uddhav Thakre, for his contribution to the find. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website ashr.com. Thank you.